And welcome to Significant TV. I'm your host, Fran McNeil, and joining me in the studio today is Suleiman W. Rahman, President and CEO of Diverse Force Incorporated. Well, welcome, and how are you this morning?
Doing very well. Glad to be here, Fran.
Well, it is a pleasure. We have known each other for a number of years, and it's been really fun to watch you progress through entrepreneurship and business, be in the city and out of the city and back again. Again, welcome.
Well, thank you very much. It's a pleasure.
Diverse Force is your current business, but I know that there is a story behind the passion that you have as an entrepreneur. Take us and the audience back to what really makes you passionate about being an entrepreneur.
Well, again, thank you very much for allowing me to be on the show, and excited to share. You know, my background, born, raised, and stayed here in Philadelphia. Mm-hmm. I started entrepreneurship many years back. It's been about 17 years. And Diverse Force is our new company, but really kind of evolution of the things we've done over the years. And we built a network that has now spans over 17,000 professionals in the region. And what really makes me passionate, what I'm excited about, is when my passion meets purpose and profitability at the same time.
The three P's.
When you bring those together, and when those all come together, I get really excited to be able to, one, be in a zone that I'm excited about, to know that we're making an impact, and that we have profitability to scale and to do it on a larger scale as well.
So I know some of your history, but our viewers may not. What was that sort of significant moment that put you on the path of entrepreneurship way back when, maybe even before 17 years ago?
Yeah, that's a good question. So I feel like I've always had sort of in my DNA entrepreneurship. When I was young, eighth grade, I won an invention contest in eighth grade. I was second place.
Okay.
And that was, I think, my first kind of entrepreneurial venture, was pursuing a patent. Saw some commercials, some infomercials on TV and on how you can patent your product. And that was a great journey. Later, got into real estate while I was in college. I got into real estate, was actually using refund checks from college to invest in properties in the New York City area.
How'd that work out for you?
It worked out well. Yeah, we were buying before the kind of University City area of Philadelphia really boomed. We're able to buy some multi-unit apartment buildings in that area, which is great. And I think that defining moment was that when I was at Penn, I was actually interning at a company. I won't say their name, but over the summer, I did a project and put a lot into it, thought this creative way that we could actually kind of solve an issue that was going on with that company. And after the summer was over, my manager kind of took all the credit for it. About later, I realized I actually was talking to a friend, and he said those things that kind of we created at that time was actually part of the company. And just thinking back, you know, at that time, I realized, you know, I have some great ideas, but many times you really can't, you know, profit from them, or you can't, you know, really get the feel of, you know, accomplishment when others may take the credit for it. So I was excited about starting my own business, being in business for myself. And that was the time when I actually went in business for myself. So around 24 is when I actually ended up leaving corporate America, or leaving a job in arena and going for myself, and been an entrepreneur ever since.
Okay. So for some folks, being an intrapreneur is really very satisfying, developing, innovating within a company. But what I hear you saying is you, particularly with the background, were ready to go out on your own. So after real estate, what was it, what did you get into at 24 that began to lay the path for where you are now with Diverse Force?
Yeah, I started a website called Urban Philly, named urbanphilly.com, which I think is
how I remember that. I remember in the early days putting my email in.
Right? Yeah, and it was this disruptive technology called email back then that allowed us to kind of be on the forefront of an industry of event marketing when a lot of the marketing was happening direct mail. And so we actually created a platform that eventually grew to over 30,000 subscribers, literally thousands of event marketers. Went on our website. It was a user-generated platform where people could upload their events. We would approve them, and people could actually see what was going on throughout the week in the region. And so that was really the start of kind of the online kind of tech side entrepreneurship, to really tap into leveraging technology to really be on the front end of a curve in the industry.
Well, let me ask, you were using technology, you were getting people involved because the purpose was, I want to put up my event, I want people to come to my event. How did you monetize that? I mean, 30,000 subscribers is pretty impressive even back then.
Yeah. So so at that time, we weren't actually doing our own events. We were actually a platform that others could advertise their events. So we were really a media platform. So advertising was our business model. It was free for the users to see what was going on. And we had advertising agencies, we had organizations, companies that would advertise, they would pay us to advertise and market events as well. But the challenge that we ran into was the fact that we didn't really have a brand that could actually mobilize. It was more us leveraging other people's content. So in 2007, we started a kind of a entity, UPPN, the Urban Philly Professional Network, with the mission to engage, empower, and connect kind of the next generation of business and civic leadership, and realize we had to kind of identify what was that avatar, you know, within our network that we would focus our content on. And it was really that 25 to 45 professionals of color, you know, in the city who are looking for cultural affiliation, ways they can be empowered to advance their career, grow a business, and to connect with others who share similar social, cultural, and intellectual interests. And so we actually started doing events, a lot of events, and that's how we started to really engage that network, build a brand for ourselves. And today, that kind of segment is, as I mentioned, over 17,000 that we're able to mobilize through events and to empower. And that was a natural kind of transition to what we're doing today.
So at one point, you moved from being 24 to getting close to that 40-year range. And when you were under 40, you were actually awarded we were one of the awardees for 40 under 40. Sure. Tell me about that, and why did the Philadelphia Business Journal select you as one of the awardees?
Yeah, so around that time, I think it was 32 years old. I had recently also been elected to chair the board for the African American Chamber of Commerce in the city. That was around the time when UPPN was really starting to pick up, and we had a pretty good ecosystem and network. I was sitting on a number of different boards throughout the city. So that, I think that presence was a big reason why they selected me as one of the 40 under 40 at that time.
Okay. So fast forward to today, Diverse Force, what does it do, and why is the purpose and the profitability and the planning, why does that all work for your clients?
Absolutely. So you, as I mentioned, UPPN, our mission is to engage, empower, connect. So engage folks in community and civic involvement, empower them to advance their career, grow their businesses, and to connect with others who share similar interests. And we wanted to find a way that, you know, we have this huge network of talent in the city, and what was the best, you know, highest and best use of this network, in which we could enrich our network, in which we can not have mission drift, and but still be able to monetize it in a meaningful way. And career and professional development and talent solutions made a lot of sense. Okay. Fit right into kind of our empowerment side of things. How do we advance people in their career? You find a lot of professionals, they have this college degree, and they're many times of color, they find themselves unemployed or underemployed at a disproportionate rate. So how do we play a role in kind of connecting with the professional, the entrepreneurship arena, as far as well as in the career space, to help people advance their career in meaningful ways. Okay. So Diverse Force was a natural solution to that, basically with a mission to, or, you know, with a role to recruit, retain, and develop talent, and help companies have a pipeline of diverse talent.
So let's talk about both sides of that in terms of solutions and some of the successes.
Sure.
What's a success story of someone who was part of the network, was maybe pursuing their career or advancing their business, and as a result of being involved with Diverse Force, said, wow, this really was a good choice for me?
Yeah, so Diverse Force is actually a newer invention, so the name, but is the evolution of UPPN, and so many great stories. I have the fortune of hearing people say, well, I met someone at your event, mm-hmm. and now I'm working here. Mm-hmm. Or I met someone at this event and at one of your events, and now, you know, they're one of my biggest clients. Mm-hmm. So tons of those stories. Recently was working with Comcast and invited some people to one of their events, and mm-hmm. a young lady, you know, just got hired, you know, with Comcast. So we've been doing this for quite some time. Also directing people and recommending them for nonprofit boards throughout the region, which helped them mm-hmm. to advance their right. career. So that's been really what we've done, you mm-hmm. know, over the last 10 years with UPPN. So Diverse Force is not, you know, is really just honing in on the value proposition to the businesses so that we can be more effective in making sure we scale it as well.
And I think that's an important lesson to share with viewers, because in having the different businesses, you've really seen how important it is to provide value. Going back, one of your core business experiences was with multi-level marketing. I'd love for you to talk about that, maybe some lessons learned that you still use today
yeah.
and are very valuable to share with others.
Well, thank you for asking. And, you know, so along this journey of entrepreneurship, there's time when you need to supplement, you know, what you're doing. Many people supplement with a job. I actually developed a skill to build kind of direct sales, network marketing organizations. And what I found was also it's like a personal development program mm-hmm. with a compensation plan attached to it. When you're around people who are doing a lot of personal development, they're speaking on it, mm-hmm. they're touching on it. So you really stay on top of your own mindset, your own belief mm-hmm. Systems. And so that's been great for me. Mm-hmm. In the beginning, it wasn't very profitable, but it was a learning experience. Mm-hmm. Later, it built a livable, you know, income. And then later I had, you know, pretty big success, you know, with another company that gave me the opportunity to travel across the country and had over 25,000 distributors around the world. And I was doing training and speaking, literally spending about $80,000 a year just traveling
wow.
and speaking to diverse audiences all across mm-hmm. the country. And the things that I've learned and now really being in this space with Diverse Force, where the talent or the career culture or talent culture has changed and companies having to adapt to it,
yes.
where it's not enough just to pay people a paycheck. You have to really tap into their passions, into their sense of social responsibility. Mm-hmm. You're seeing a whole different type of employee coming into the workforce, and they're not gonna be there for 30, 40 years. It's gonna
Absolutely
be there for two,
not.
3 years. So
exactly.
It's important to understand how to recruit, retain that talent and to help them advance through mentorship, through inspiration. So I found that a lot of the skills and things we had to learn in an industry that was commission-based only to tap into people's, you know, intrinsic motivations
right.
And their human needs, you know, not just the income, you learn those things and we can kind of take a page out of that book to help companies to be more intentional about making sure they're providing value intrinsically for their employees, to keep them longer, to make them happy, you know, and more and happier employees are more productive employees.
Absolutely. So, Lamont, as we wrap up, you have a lot of lessons that you've learned and probably many that you share when you speak and talk with others. What's one lesson that you'd like to leave our audience with?
Yeah, I would say work on yourself more than you work on your business. Who you become is very important. At the end of the day, you want to attract things to you and not necessarily have to chase it mm-hmm. all the time. So that's been really a mission for me, and also to make sure that you focus on your own fulfillment.
Mm-hmm.
It's one thing to have financial revenue. It's another thing to have the emotional and spiritual revenue that goes along with impacting others through social entrepreneurship. And it was John C. Maxwell, and it goes well with your title here. He said, success is when you add value to self, significance when you add value to others. So how do you become that person that can be impactful and also be free
right.
and creative?
Right.
Use the opportunity that we've all been given, the opportunity to kind of use our imagination to create our future and to turn it into reality.
Wow. Powerful. Thank you, Suleiman.
My pleasure.
Thank you very much. Significant business results. Significant TV. Suleiman Rahman. You know, it's so exciting to have folks that understand business, that touch others, that motivate others. And Suleiman with Diverse Force is doing just that. Join us as we continue our journey of significance.